Hey folks, welcome back to Let's Play Grand Theft Auto V. I'm the mysterious JG. I'm in a good mood. It's a Friday evening as I am recording this one, and I've gotten into a habit, usually Fridays and sometimes a different night of the week near the end of the work week. Probably got to stop doing this because it's expensive and it's not great for your waistline, but I've been just almost pretty much every week, once a week, like clockwork, I'm going out having a steak dinner at a restaurant, putting in headphones, going to a restaurant by myself. Don't give a crap who's looking at the weird guy eating by himself in the restaurant, putting on some headphones, enjoying a steak dinner at a mid-range steak joint, and just enjoying myself. So other than the fact that it's a little late to be starting a session, so I might yawn. I'm in just good spirits. So what I thought I would do, also, just because of circumstances, I was recording Grand Theft Auto 5 a couple of days ago just to have stuff for this weekend, and now I unexpectedly have this moment. I'm getting ahead, a little bit, I guess. Yeah, not really getting ahead, but I'm in a good mood playing GTA 5, and I was like, you know what? While I'm in a good mood, not to spoil my mood. But while I'm in a good mood, let's knock out these stock market assassination missions. Because once I've done that, I could just I was all like, oh, buy a helicopter, slip as Franklin. And then I didn't get a helicopter, and now I just want to say, like any money I spend after that point will be like, oh, well, as long as I don't completely run out of money with any of the pro tags, it's fine. And Trevor already owns like a business. He owns two businesses. I bought the airfield that you can only buy with Trevor, so I probably would have done that anyway just to showcase it. I brought the hen house bar, which means we can see those missions. Like, I won't necessarily bother to buy like Tequila La La or, some of the other businesses that just, functionally are the same. As other, I won't buy another bar because the bar missions are pretty much the same. And you can't really afford to buy all the properties in game under normal circumstances unless you wait and finish the main story anyway. And then take the big cash that the game dumps on you for finishing the main story to give you a reason to play around and have fun in the post game. They give you a bunch of cash. And then if you use the assassination missions to inflate that by like several 100%. Then I think you get to where you can afford to buy every property in the game. So since we're not going to do that anyway, let's just get the money that our pro tags are going to have, and then I won't worry about, oh, that was a. It's silly, but I am caught up on the idea that, oh, I don't want to buy something now that will cut into any of the pro tags' money because I'm about to increase their money again by, 50% or whatever by doing these missions. So let's just get them out of the way. And that being said, I took a quick glance, and then the two assassination missions we have left to do are probably going to be simpler. The stock manipulation part, which was eating up so much of my time and energy before, is probably simpler for these. Like one of them, all you do is buy a stock immediately after the mission is done and sell it a few days later. And then the other one, there's one where you buy something before the mission, then do the mission, and then sell it. And then there's another one where you do the mission at like you, there's nothing where I'm doing two different manipulations. But the guide that is the most detailed does ask you to start on Monday, so I think that might slightly tweak things. Speaking of tweaking, here's our tweaker. Trevor sleeps 12 hours a pop, which is like these are the little touches that you don't know unless you're like paying attention, which obviously I'm not, or you're reading guides. Like, yeah, Michael and Franklin kind of sleep for normal amounts of time. Trevor just sleeps for 12 hours at a time. And I want to say that maybe once or twice in my life I have slept for 12 hours. And like I mean like once or twice in my life, like something was going on medically where I slept for like 12 hours. It is not a normal thing. But Trevor seems like somebody whose drug habits might mean that he might stay up 3 or 4 days and then sleep for 12 hours. Trevor's kind of a beloved character. I think the voice actor for Trevor does a lot of cameos now. It's a bit like Patrick Troughton. Like I remember reading that Patrick Troughton, who was the second Doctor in Doctor Who, would do. He'd kind of be like halfway between being in character as a Doctor and out of character at like fan conventions and stuff. I think the guy who plays Trevor does these kind of like half in character as Trevor, half just being himself cameos, which seem like they'd be really fun, but they betray this like fondness that people have for Trevor as a character, which I think is just completely messed up. Trevor's a fucking awful person. Not just because he killed Johnny Schnabitz.
Hey, I'm going, man, before you take advantage.
People will point out, like, oh, but Trevor believes in loyalty and this. Like, yeah, there are positive traits you can find in Trevor, but. So why isn't our vehicle here? This is annoying. Yeah, there are positive traits you can find in Trevor, but like you're seeking them out as exceptions, not as the rule. He's like a murdering psychopath. All right, so this is slightly annoying. I was hoping we could just is this the husk of a car or just a really shitty car? It's the husk of a car. Okay. I wanted to throw down a save with Franklin while it's like really l late on Sunday night so that his so that it would be Sunday or so that it would be Monday morning at the end of that save file. You got a red light, man. Yeah, come on, stop so I can see your car.
Oh shit.
And by man, of course, I mean woman. That's Nigel. We're always making plans for Nigel. Always. This is not exactly a high-speed vehicle that we're using to get to this location either. So I read up a little bit on what we like. I saw the names of the missions, and I read up a little bit on the stock manipulation. But I've avoided spoiling for myself what these assassinations will entail, which is good, I think. No way! Some guys have stole one of our delivery vans. I don't know. I'm sorry. I'd like to do something about that, but I mean, I should because it means we'll get our money, but our money won't show up immediately. It'll show up after I've done the assassination missions anyway, so whatever. Again, I find myself being really hard on Rockstar games. I think because they're so good, it's like the things that they don't do well are really noticeable because of how many things they do so well. So, like, the way that property and money making works in this game has there are little things about it that bug me that I wish they did better. Like, it seems like really infrequent that you get money from your properties. You have to own your in-game property. Like, a ton of time has to pass before any of the properties that make money could possibly pay for themselves. Like, I read the guide. Like, buying property in this game is... It is about... In the single-player mode, at least. It is about feeling like, you know, role-playing that you're these wealthy criminal dudes. Or I guess you could think of it in the sense as, like, laundering the money from their criminal... Because it doesn't really make sense that they would just have access to, like, a cash equivalent amount from, like, you know, fencing jewels and shit, so... Like, I'm glad that the story has Lester providing a mansion to Franklin, because the idea that Franklin would just take a cash payout from a jewelry heist and buy a mansion and that the IRS wouldn't be knocking, like, Lester probably found some kind of way to make this work on paper. Although, actually, I do kind of wonder, why is this aunt not calling the FBI or somebody? And if I said FBI in the first part of that, I should have said IRS. He's still got a picture of him and his old girl. Like, I kept thinking she got mentioned frequently enough at the beginning of the game that I figured she would show up, but I think she does exist in the like the game, the in-game Facebook. Like, you can find out what's happening with her, maybe even send her messages and shit, but I mean, please find below your weekly income. Oh, it's going to show that I, never mind. Maybe I could have affected this. Oh no, we did get. See, this is what's so weird. Like, we got a message. Oh, smoke on the water needs help. But like, it's all out of sync. Like, now the next month we won't get our money. Whatever. All right, so if we can avoid accidentally getting chop. It's annoying. I wanted our super cool motorbike. But whatever. It's Monday morning. Let's all go to the lobby. Let's go to a nice, conveniently nearby assassination mission. Let's fill up the plate right now with collard greens. Okay, that's the name of the I guess the band? Like, I know I sound like an elderly white man, but like, what? It's like if you a rap band that like calling rap artists who are like a collective group of rap artists like. You know, the Wu-Tang Clan is my favorite rap band. Like, I know how bad that sounds, but like, what is the correct? Are they a rap group? Are they rap artists? Because I mean, I guess you could call like traditional rock and roll bands like rock artists, but it no, they're bands. The Rolling Stones are like one of the all-time great bands. But the Wu-Tang Clan would not be considered a rap band, I don't think. Icky, icky. Is he seriously calling from a payphone? Is that a thing? Wow. All right, Lester. Get to the phone on Liberty Park.
So who the fuck don't you like today?
Guy's called Isaac Penny, ruthless vulture capitalist, about to take a controlling interest in Vapid Motor Company and sell thousands of workers down the river. Penny's one of those tight-fisted billionaires, rides the same bus to and from work every day. I was thinking you could take over the route and
drop the ass off where he needs to go. I've got him.
Good. Oh, one thing. If I was you, I wouldn't buy any Vapid stock until the acquisition falls through.
Well, they did a dumb thing. I forgot to refresh my memory on the buying part of this. So okay, vulture capital like that. That's a term I really like because it really like. I guess I don't want to just start a flame war with venture capitalists, but like, yeah, there's a class, kind of all venture capitalists, but some venture capitalists very specifically. Yeah, like it bugs me. Like you read about. I was going to drop a name, but I probably shouldn't because there might be some factual thing I got wrong. But like, there are some pretty high up there. Like, some of them are even politicians, or like people who get into politics after making money and talking about, oh, successful businessman, I know how to make the economy work. And then you find out that what they did is take capital. In some cases, that they got from their parents' businesses, but in some cases, they kind of got to start doing something else. And then once they had some capital, they used it to buy companies. Fire everybody, go public, and then dump their shares. Like that, it makes me mad because I know just enough about how it works to know how fucking heartless it is. And if you do that, and then like you're from Utah and you call yourself a passionate conservative, well, never mind. Let's not start talking about an actual real life person. All right, so for this one, okay, I got lucky. I forgot. And I didn't look, but this was the one where we don't have anything we have to do other than make sure it's Monday before we do this. So after we do the mission, we have to invest all of our money immediately in Vapid stocks because after we kill the CEO of it, they're going to tank. And then we buy them and then we sell them when it rebounds. So when he says, I wouldn't buy it until after it recovers, until after the merger fails to go through, I guess that's the game's way of saying, I wouldn't buy it until after you kill the guy. Whereas in some of these, like you're supposed to buy the competitor stock and then kill somebody, and the competitor stock skyrockets. So this one is just, there's purely a single stock that's going to nosedive, and we want to buy when it does. Although, there's nothing about the situation where Lester knows that it's going to recover. It's just, that's the way these stocks work in this game. They always recover. All right, so this one I think sounds like it's kind of fun. We're just going to take over a bus and like drive it off a cliff or something. But anyway, I think our return for this one, if I'm under, it should be about 100%. I think this thing is going to bottom the fuck out. And then just because of the way the in-game markets work, it's going to just get back eventually over a couple of days to what it normally. I think all the stocks in this game kind of have a range that they drift back and forth across kind of semi-randomly. So this one's just going to return to its normal range after the story event makes it bottom out. Out, out, out. Aren't even gonna put on some kind of bus strap or like, you know, Ralph Cramden outfit here. To the moon, Alice's. Alice. Alice's. No music on this bus? Here's a station we don't normally listen to because it's not anybody's default station in their car. Which means I'm setting myself up for copyright
Hey,
strikes for
sorry,
the
I'm
first
late.
time in a
It's
long
my
ass
first day
time.
on the job.
We're not late.
I hope the traffic isn't too bad. Yesterday it took me 3 hours to go half a mile.
Well, the bus is empty, that's why I'm able to hear you. Okay, this song's boring. Well, there you go. British rap is kind of an interesting subgenre. Not really a subgenre, it's a genre of its own. I don't know if British rap is the correct name to use for it.
Damn, would it kill you people to crack a smile?
Yeah, that's it. Just yell at them angrily. That will make them happier. Beating's gonna continue to morale improve. Why are you guys so upset? It's like you know that you're all gonna die shortly. Bad boy MC. How late are we really running though? I feel like we're making good time. They're complaining about it. It took like 3 hours to move one block because of the traffic. Like, there's never traffic like this in this game. That in this game, it just doesn't happen. Like, I, you know, occasionally make a visit to a big city for, you know, work or pleasure. Not often. I wouldn't mind driving through the middle of Manhattan, like, if it looked like this. Or Los Angeles, I guess I should say, since that's where this is supposed to be.
Late? That'll be 150. Mr. Penny, ain't he?
Fahrenheit. Forget about it. Spendthrifts.
Hey! Hey, I thought you needed a ride.
I guess it's amusing that he stole a bike even though he's a millionaire.
Attention passengers. Please hold on to your fucking seats.
Stop the bus, you maniac.
Just get on the bus, man. We saved the seat for you and everything. We're taking a short detour, ladies and gentlemen. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the beautiful downtown of Los Santos. What's with the fucking bike, man? Just business shit. You know how it is.
Oh, well, the wanted level went away. Oh, no, it didn't. Alright, well, I guess I just want to not be seen. Yeah, never mind, they saw me. Yeah, hiding spot, like, the game really, I don't know, it works differently. It's not like an Assassin's Creed style hiding where you just have to find approved hiding places and hide there. This game really does want you to get pretty far away from the site of the crime. I should be moving in the general direction of our home, but not necessarily towards this cop. The enemy. Cops are everywhere. Enemy is everywhere. Hold the line. Are they suddenly not up here anymore? For some reason, they're not up here anymore. Well, they're not looking for me anymore, so.
Green light.
Good to go.
Hey, I got gold. Hidden run bonus. Time taken. Oh, I got a check mark for earning money. I don't understand how that even is a check mark. So we probably missed hilarious dialogue from Franklin. Alright, so what's the stock we're supposed to buy? And do I want to buy it before throwing down that save? Vapid stocks on the Boss Walk site. Market is down for maintenance. Please try again later. Got a lot of unannounced stoners over here, man. Well, you don't even have the option of responding to that guy because he's not really a character. I feel like Zero, the guy who runs the RC store in San Andreas, and like the 90s should still be around and running Smoke on the Water for no reason. Or just all businesses should have David Cross back. Elderly David Cross is the owner of all these businesses that you have to interact with. Oh, that's right. I didn't actually... I wasn't too far off, but yeah, I didn't actually... I just set to a place that was nearby where I thought it was, so I didn't actually. I was like, this doesn't look right. Oh, because it isn't. Well, hopefully it won't tell me that I should have had a parachute for this, but let's here we go. Vapid down 66.82. And our bike has returned home. Shut up. No care. Alright, so we'll throw down a save and then let's see what is it at? It's at $80.81. So if it's if we sleep for 4 or 6 hours or whatever, and it's significantly higher than that, then I guess I can decide that I feel that it's worth freaking loading the autosave. Now 80.81, exactly the same. Okay. Can't just jump to it from there. Doesn't say main stories, doesn't actually show. Now it says down 45.2. Well, whatever. The price is this, right? Current price is 8.81. Now, Bill manufactured the pioneer of the great American business model of low quality mass production. So we do want to keep an eye on that 80.81 and see if I should have waited. Like, if it goes down lower, then we could have waited and got an even better low sort of. Like, I know it sounds silly, but these percentages make a difference. If it goes from 80 to 40, even if it gets back up to like 160 or whatever, I mean, we could have bought twice as much. So we definitely want to. Oh, and we got right to the penny here. No, we didn't. Never mind. All right, so this one. This one we should, if I understand it correctly, get about 100% return. We should be doubling our money. Again, this makes a bigger. Percentage wise, it's the same, but actual dollars wise, it's. Michael, he takes care of this place while the master is away. He's the one who ends up getting the most out of this. He's going to end up with, like, if we don't get $40 million with him out of this, I'll be disappointed that we didn't do as well as we were supposed to. Even the process of buying all the stocks with him takes a minute because he's buying so many flipping stocks. He's buying 200,000 stocks. 200,000 shares, almost 300,000 shares. And he's got negative $1 now. I don't know how that works. I guess they let me round off to the nearest dollar to buy a share. And honestly, like, I know we're putting in these trades at the same time, which should really be, like, if anybody were to do some kind of forensic audit behind this, like, these three guys would all be busted. Like, this should be setting off some warning bells of the SEC, but that's annoying. I'm gonna have to go all the way back. Oh, our driving skills have increased. How could you not want me? I've got perfect driving power, and I'm about to get super rich. All right, so I tell you what I might do here. Because we're at the end of a video. I might be generous. A generous lover. No, I might be generous here and make this purchase, then drive, then have the long drive with Trevor all the way to his top secret headquarters in the desert. Sleep and get to the point where we're selling the stock off screen. Like, even though Nigel's right there, I think that's probably the smart thing to do here. So when we come back next time, we'll be ready to sell these stocks. Catch you then.